Morning, everybody. Welcome back to Brandon Lester Fishing. Hey, I'm crappie fishing again today. The air temperature this morning, about 60 degrees or so. It's supposed to get up to almost 70 today, so pretty warm. It's been cold the past few days. We actually had a couple of nights that went down into the 30s, so the water temperature got down. It's down to almost 60 degrees now. Back on Tim's Ford Lake today, like I said. I've got some crappie right over here under a dock. I just side scanned this dock and there's several crappie sitting under there. So I'm going to get rigged up here. We'll see if we can catch a couple. I don't have real long to fish today. Only got a few hours. So we're going to see if we can catch a few. It's kind of cloudy, a little bit of wind. They should be biting today. So stay tuned. We'll see if we can catch some. All right, guys, I'm pretty much going to use the same rig. I'm going to start out with about the same rig I used last time. In the last video, I've got that same 1/32 ounce Mustad jig head, a ghost colored Bobby Garland. Since it is cloudy this morning, I'm actually going to take this as a chartreuse dye marker. And I'm just going to dye just the very tip of that tail. See, I just put a little bit of chartreuse dye right there on the tip of that tail on that ghost color jig, just to give it a little bit of contrast on this cloudy morning. We're gonna ease right over here by this dock and see if we can catch us a couple this morning. First one of the morning. Not a great big one, but I think he's a keeper. Let's check him here. They gotta be 10 inches. Tennessee state law on that one is about 10, a little over 10 and a half. Fish number one, we're gonna keep us about 5 or 6 today. That fish was pretty shallow. You can see what I'm looking at right here on active target. There's the crappie sitting under the dock right there. They're just sitting right under those pontoon floats. And I'm gonna have to shoot it a little bit better than that to get them to bite. A little bit nicer. Yeah, that was a little bit better. After I caught that first one, they moved down just a little bit deeper. It's number two. That one feels a little bit better. Oh yeah, that's a good one. That's more like what we're talking about. I thought them jokers would be biting this morning, and they are. Some days, I'm sure y'all know what I'm talking about. Some days you put your boat in the water and you can just feel it in the air, man. It's cloudy this morning. There's just a perfect amount of little breeze on the lake. I just knew when I got here they were gonna be biting, which My motto is they're always biting somewhere, but I thought they'd be biting pretty good this morning, and they are. That was a pretty decent one. He hit it on the fall. I've been fishing this dock for a few minutes, and I saw those fish in there on active target. And that little hook. I think he's going to be a 10-incher. He's not a great big one, but, oh yeah, he's a little over 11 inches. Pretty nice little fish. I'm on a different part of the lake today. And the fish aren't quite as fat up this way. I've noticed that already. But I saw these fish on this dock on active target. And I just couldn't ever get my jig to them. That's the cool part about it. You can tell exactly where those fish are. See right here? Now there's a lot of crappie swimming around, or a lot of bluegill, I'm sorry. There's a lot of bluegill swimming around up high. But when you see stuff stacked like that, that's the crappie. That's what you want to look for. I finally weaseled my way around this dock, and I figured out exactly where these fish were sitting and where I could get to them. I didn't quite get to them that time. I mean, I missed them by maybe 3 or 4 feet. Got to him that time. We should get one right there. All right, my jig's sinking down to him. I'm watching that line while it's sinking. Let it sink about 7 or 8 seconds. One hit it. Oh, he hit it on the fall. I just saw my line jump. Now that's a little bit better one there. Oh yeah. That's a nice one. So important. I can't stress to y'all how important it is to watch that line while that jig's falling. Y'all can see I went to a chartreuse jig there also. I broke off a second ago, and I just thought I'd try that solid chartreuse, and they're liking it pretty well. That's a little bit better fish there. That's five of them. We'll catch us about one more to keep and take home, and then we'll throw the rest of them back. There, boy. I was letting it go too deep, what it was. That's a big fat one. That one. That's a nice one. I was throwing it in there, and I was counting 7, 8 seconds. That's what I've been catching most of them at. I noticed on my active target, I saw several sitting up high in like 4 foot. So I just pitched in there and let it sink about 3 seconds. Started reeling it, and I caught one of them. He is. That's all I had to do was just shallow up just a little bit. I was letting it go too deep. Something y'all need to realize about crappie, and I can't remember if I've talked about this on my channel, but it's very important. You always want to fish above crappie. That's six for today. That's all I'm gonna keep. I'm gonna let the rest of them go. But something you gotta realize about crappie, they always feed up. And When I was a kid, I never really understood that. That's an old saying. My papa used to always tell me that when we used to fish when I was a kid, and I didn't really understand what he was saying. But a crappie, you'll almost, and Active Target has even showed me this even more, a crappie almost never feeds down. You'll almost never catch a crappie off the bottom. The only time you'll ever see a crappie feed off the bottom is when they're spawning. That's about the only time. So you always, if you just say, for instance, right here, I saw these crappie sitting in about 5 foot. Well, I only want to let my jig sink to about 3 foot and let them come up to get it. Crappie hardly ever feed down. So keep that in mind. If you think you see some fish on your depth finder in 10 feet of water, you need to try to be fishing for those fish in about 7 or 8 feet. There he is. I got him. Changed colors and he come out there and grabbed it. He couldn't take it. That one's keeper size, but I got me 6 nice ones in the live well. That's good enough for today. I'm gonna throw that one back. All right, everybody, that's gonna wrap it up for today. Like I said, I only had a couple hours this morning. Man, I just wanted to go crappie fishing. I just wanted to go catch a few. So, you know, we caught 10 or 12 in a couple of hours, caught me 6 good keepers and kept them for supper tonight. So, I'm going to get home. I got some stuff to do around the house. We got some more bass fishing videos coming up. I'm going to do some bass fishing later on in the week. So y'all stay tuned for that. I know I got some crappie guys on here. I got some bass guys on here. And my goal with this channel is to create content that everybody likes and that everybody can relate to. So, you know, we'll see what we get into next time, but I'm certainly not done bass fishing. I just like taking a little bit of a break from the bass fishing in the wintertime and do some crappie fishing, man. It's just fun. But we'll be bass fishing some more here pretty soon. So y'all hang in there with me. I appreciate you watching. Hit that subscribe button if you hadn't. I'll see you next time right here. Brandon Lester Fishing.